Hello, 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 hello. Yeah, my name is Vincent Nememan, as always, and this is Mika Life YouTube channel, your life in fullness. Now, today we are back after elections, after your Christmas, after the lockdown of the internet. Yeah, internet is still locked down anyway. And after all, everything, we are back to the real mission of changing your life, giving you a fulfilled life, not through words, not through anything, but giving you Christian based inspirations that are biblical and relevant to your life. So we are going to stay to the true mission of Mikra Life, which is to inspire you to live a fulfilled life through Christ or through Jesus. We shall achieve this mission by sharing Christian based inspirations and in various aspects of your life, especially in relationships and the daily activities of a Christian, so that we see how you can live each day satisfied and pleased and joyful in God, you know, in God and God alone, not in anything else, but in God and God alone. So we are back. So we are going to explore a very big topic about life purpose. What is life purpose? Life without purpose can't be. I mean, imagine waking up and you do not have what motivates you, what moves you to act, to say, to think the way you do. So life purpose gives us directions and it gives us the strength to overcome roadblocks, to overcome obstacles, because we know what we want, we know where we are going, we know what we are aiming at. It's easy to overcome obstacles and continue on your journey. But when you don't have something that motivates you to be who you are, to say what you say, to do what you do, to think what you think, to not do what you not do, then it becomes hard, especially when you have challenges. You just go where the wind takes you. So imagine yourself, you are sailing on water, but you don't have a destination. When wind comes, when the wave comes, you just go wherever it takes you. Because after all, you didn't have where you're going, so you can't fight back to regain your control, to regain your way, your path. After all, you didn't have one. I want to remind you again, this is New Year 2021, and we have a target of hitting between 1.5 to 2K subscribers, and we can't do that minus you being part of us. So please hit that subscribe button. Watching alone is not really enough. You have to support this YouTube channel by just subscribing, so that you never miss any new videos coming from this channel. So hit that subscribe button down there and hit the bell icon that shows there after as well, so that it keeps reminding you whenever I post a new video on this YouTube channel. To tell you what your life purpose is, it is one of the long represented topic in this world. And one of the reasons why it is so common to find false answers to what life purpose is because we rarely define what it means. So without clear definition of life purpose, then we have different views. And by the way, always fear a question that has various answers. As I mean, if you googled, the answers can surprise you. Everyone has different answers. If you went on YouTube and you typed, what is life purpose? Very many videos come up, but with false and very confusing information, and they are famous videos. So I tried to type this, what is life purpose, on Quora. The world is top number one Q&A platform. The answers almost made me mad. Everyone has his way of defining it, and that can make you go crazy. As in, we are too much subjective when it comes to life purpose, that it all becomes useless. So it's very important that we define what life purpose is. In today's video, we are going to explore what it means by life purpose, the definition of life purpose. Okay, so we believe that when we have got a clear definition of what we mean whenever we talk about life purpose or the meaning of life, then we shall be in a position to discuss what it is for us when we know what it is by definition. When we say, hey, what do you think is the meaning of life? Why do we live? What is the purpose of life? What exactly are we meaning? What question are we asking? So in today's video, we're going to embark on definition, what people and scholars think life purpose is. Most people define life purpose based on what you do. As in, many scholars, many authors, when they are telling you they are defining life purpose, they're actually saying that which you do, that which you contribute to the world. They can say life purpose is that which you do, that which you contribute to the world, the one thing you wake up to. Others say life purpose is happiness. Others say life purpose is living according to God's will, pleasing God. But so many people don't even believe in existence of God. So how do they define living according to God's will? But by the end of this whole discussion, whether you believe in God or not, you will have realized that what you believe in has no truth. So when you fail to provide evidence to give important logical explanations for what you believe in as your life purpose, then you will have to forcefully go with our position. My point here is to be able to stand with you also, and I bring out your point, I try to urge it out and what gives you confidence, and then I break it with time, showing why you should go with the position. My position is life purpose isn't external to your existence. I'm trying to figure out life purpose as the meaning of your existence. So it doesn't matter what you do, who you are, the externals. No, it's just about why are we alive? Why are we here? It's about what is the purpose of just being alive. That's what I think. Now, to me, I think life purpose is not what you do. That is very small. Now, take for example, actually a good definition from the theology of work. Perhaps we should think about our life purpose less in terms of accomplishments and more in terms of faithfulness, even in small things. In other words, it is possible for the physically incapacitated to actually live fully their true life purpose, as it is for anyone else. This is because life purpose isn't about material or even psychological accomplishments like peace, calmness, happiness, balance, self-esteem, and more, but living faithfully in line with the Creator's grand purpose. But like we have said, when we talk about Creator's grand purpose, so many people don't believe in that. So where shall we put them? That's why we shall go back to philosophy and science and discuss their points, their standing, their logical explanations for what they stand for, and we see if it has water. Life purpose is the main theme for your life. It's the reason you do what you do. Actually, what we do, what we don't do, are simply the means of accomplishing that grand vision of our lives. So life purpose is much more bigger than what we do, the successes, the failures. It's beyond that. It's the central theme that governs every decision, every action, every sleeping, every waking up, every thinking, every not thinking. It's everything. Our failures, our successes, our good things, our bad things, our everything comes into that one grand purpose of life. See how I wrote it at www.nemvix.com. Of course, I want to remind you that every video I share here, there is always an article and a PDF version. You can get a PDF and ebook version of it at www.nemvix.com by getting the article, read it, or print it out as a PDF, or print it out as an ebook. I've given you all the tools at www.nemvix.com, and don't forget to join the community at Mikra Life, that website. So even this video, just go to www.nemvix.com and check out the whole article that has details and links more than actually I have put in this video. Here is how I wrote about it. Life purpose is that aim that isn't lost when your dreams crash, when your business shut down, when your life is cut short by an accident and you lose the arms and legs or the eyes and ears that you are using to serve. life purpose is that thing that is not lost because of those shortcomings. You are getting me now? Yes. So life purpose isn't about your accomplishments. That's part of it. It's one way of doing it. But even your failures, what you do, what you don't do, is all part of the grand purpose. Now, we have to define life purpose before we go deeper. Because if we go deeper, we anyway are still thinking life purpose is what you do, the things you set out to be. Then we shall have issues discussing this in front. Life purpose goes beyond that. It is just the sole aim for living. Life purpose isn't about success. Living the most successful and wealthy life isn't necessarily the same as living your life purpose. That's the definition I'm trying to give. It is the central theme for our life's existence. Whether we succeed, whether we lose, whether we do, whether we don't do, all those come into one thing. It's not what you set out to be. Now, so many scholars, so many speakers out there, motivational speakers, are telling you that life purpose is sitting and figuring out those goals in life, the big goals, the things you want to live for, what you want to do to contribute to the world. That is life purpose. Very, very myopic, very, very small. It can't be. Now, what if you die? What if your leg, what if your wisdom, what if the things that were helping you to achieve the goals stop and you can't achieve any of the goals you put on the list? Will you have lived your purpose? Shouldn't your purpose go beyond the physical incapacitations of this life? Think about it. It can't be. It can't be your goals. That's very small. You can't live to become a teacher. You can't live to just educate others. You can't live to just It can't be. That's very small, but can be part of it. I agree. It can be. But there is something that moves you to do those things. To die for a country. To sing a song. To start a charity organization. To become a teacher. To become a doctor. To become a coach. To do what you do. To not do what you do. To not become a driver. To not become a DJ. There are those inner inspirations that move us to do, to be, to think what we do. And that's what life purpose is, the central theme, the central vision for your life's existence. Very internal, not external. It's not about your accomplishments. Rick Warren, the famous author of Purpose-Driven Life book. By the way, I have that book, and it's one of the best books when it comes to life purpose, at least. He instructs us and says, without God, life has no purpose. And without purpose, life has no meaning. Without meaning, life has no significance or hope. But like I said, that vision is sweet and nice, but those who believe in God. So what if people don't believe in God? The general definition I would like us to take here forward, which is not very biased, is that from Reker and Wong, 1988. They define life purpose as this. Life purpose is cognizance or recognition of order, coherence and purpose in one's existence. The pursuit of worthwhile goals and an accompanying sense of fulfillment. That is the best definition, which is not too much theological and not too much physical, as in the scientific, but that brings it a little bit closer by the word fulfillment. It is whatever they have put forward, there should be an accompanying sense of fulfillment, of satisfaction, of feeling it is complete, it is done. In the next videos, we shall discuss details regarding the different epistemological ways of finding out life purpose, whether it could be theology, it could be philosophy, it could be science and psychology. We shall look at all possible areas, possible scholarly work, and come up with all the logical explanations that really could help you figure out what life purpose is, that grand theme, grand vision for your life's existence, for the things you do and you don't do, for your living, for your death, for your everything. That's the life purpose. For now, ciao, ciao.